be very effective, and I imagine that's going to be the case here. But we'll have to see, as Dignitas definitely proving that they're very strong with this new Lucio buff, and Evoke doing a lot to make good use of those changes. And reinforce right now on the Winston to start things off.
Yeah, so we do have that triple tank setup coming out on the side of Dignitas, as they are going to be starting off with defense. Over on the offense, though, nothing quite locked in. I don't know if Mattson is going to go ahead and push forward with that Widow, but he is out the gates with that grapple shot. Doesn't quite connect. Immediately goes back to the spawn to switch off. Mattson is going to be on that Tracer now. So I got a triple DPS dive composition already coming out on the side of Misfits here, as the payload is going to get stopped at the bend so far. Lynx here, hook out, not going to be able to quite connect with it right now. Now they are on the hunt. Toxic and getting focused down. Currently, he does have the projected barrier, but it's going to be Bromos that gets that first kill onto Zebesai.
And it actually looks like Misfits is battling back into this one. I mean, Toxican and Bromus definitely doing good to start things off the way that they did, but still the payload is in motion here, Jamerson. They're still pushing this one forward, and the defensive side still needs to get back into position if they want to make a hold here. And now it actually is going to be Manitin sliding around, does have the pulse bomb, throws it out, gets a nice bit of damage actually off, but Lynx are finding the kill on Reinforce. Should be all that they need to start the momentum of pushing back in, and it is going to be Bromus taken down pretty low, but not actually eliminated. Manitin needs to get out of here pretty quickly, has that triple blink available, only needs a double to get away, but he might actually decide to stay. Still though, the defensive hold here from Dignitas proving to be pretty strong so far, and Misfits need to regroup here if they want to move this payload.
Yeah, towards the end there, Zabe was just on the hunt for Vayneless. Vayneless dropped down to about 10 HP, and he just jumped onto the payload trying to get that kill. Unfortunately, wasn't able to connect onto it. That would have been a huge pickup, but right now it's just going to be a reset. Misfits, they've got 2 minutes and 24 seconds left to push into. Vic does have that tactical visor at the ready, but Bromos is getting closer and closer towards his.
Now, Bromos in a very good position, taking advantage of the fact that nobody is looking down that sightline of that cave up top. And now Reinforce jumping into the back line, taking down Toxican pretty low. And we do see Bromos pulling out the tac visor of his own right after Tevik gets eliminated when he pulls his out. And Reinforce trying to create the distance here and separate the rest of the team, and actually does a fantastic job of that with Zebesai supporting him there as well. And Zebesai going to be taken out by Lynxer. And Lynxer, again, making the plays here for Dignitas as they're looking to make this hold yet again, and someone needs to shut this guy out or he's going to be continuing to become a problem. Nonetheless, Misfits still able to move that payload forward here, Jamerson, and it looks as though we have a lot of options on the table for Dignitas.
A lot of options is a definite understatement. Zabe pushes forward with that sound barrier and Reinforce getting that first kill onto Bromos, but still the tools are in place. Graviton Surge comes out. It's not going to connect onto anyone as the Pulse Bomb is used by Monotin. Now they're starting to clean up. Unfortunately, on the side of Dignitas, they just were not able to find anything with it. Now they're getting cleaned up, and what looked like what should have been a great defense just kind of went squandered there. And so Misfits will be able to secure this first checkpoint with a minute left on their clock.
And now they're going to go forward and try to get some early ult charge as well. Tevik certainly going to be looking for that tac visor. Didn't get too much out of it the last time around, but I mean, he had everybody right in his face trying to shut him out. But now he's going to be able to put some nice bit of damage onto Bromos and backing them up. Manitin actually taking down pretty low as Nevik's actually coming alive with that Dragon Blade. Only going to find Vayneless there, but still Misfits with a little bit of an advantage as they take out both the Ana and the Reinhardt. Those are going to be very, very solid picks. Discord out onto Bromos. That's going to give Tevik a pretty good advantage going into that fight. And again, payload in the meantime, just moving this entire time here for Misfits.
Yeah, Lynxer though connects with that hook. Unfortunately, isn't able to get that follow-up damage. Now Reinforced once again with that Primal Rage, is batting everyone around. Nevix will be able to get the kill onto Toxican. Evoke is just going to go ahead and reset himself. Now they're setting a great time so far with this payload. They've got 3 people on it right now pushing it forward. There is going to be another opportunity for Dignitas to try and come in, but they don't have quite the ultimates they want to be working with for this hole. They do have that sound barrier along with that whole hog. It's going to be very difficult trying to make this entry.
Reinforce looking to jump in, and we do see the sound barrier coming out already from Evoke, as Toxican actually going to be eliminated there, and Nevix actually coming through, getting a reset, and now looking to try to take on Bromos. Again, Bromos needs to be dealt with here for Dignitas, but Lynx are coming through and making a nice hook play. Not going to be able to find the follow-up damage, and Misfits pushing it through once again here with just under 2 minutes. They're able to cap this out and now send it up to about 3.5 as they're going into the last stage of the map here on Route 66 and looking a lot better than that first couple of those first couple attempts on that first point. Nevix coming back around, has that Dragon Blade coming up pretty soon. Definitely going to be looking for him to pull that out. Manitin swapping off the Tracer, going over to that what is essentially a Graviton Surge bot. And Linxer again! These hooks are insane!
It's going to be a one-for-one trade now as the charge does not actually connect on to reinforce from What7. So the payload's still getting pushed up here now. What7 getting to be able to get some swings off. He's at 67%, but it's going to be reinforced with that hammer. Takes out Bromos. Now they're still trying to contest at the point, but this entire time, just Tevik just getting off free damage as the Dragon Blade does come out from Nevix. Another one-for-one trade, but finally the Blade starting to get the resets in. They're going to be able to get this wipe force back. Linxer. Linxer is now getting hunted down by the majority of Misfits. He will fall. So the defense, though, they've got a lot of tools to work with as we do enter into this final stretch of Route 66.
The problem is that they're going to have to deal with Tevik going with that attack visor, and I mean, if Zebesai gets a little bit more ult charge here, he's going to be in a great position to nano boost him a little bit late, but should give Tevik a lot of state potential as well. And we do see the nano boost coming out onto the Roadhog as he's just unleashing the whole hog. Vayne's going to get down pretty low. Nevix coming in to try to support that kill. They do eventually find it, but Bromas coming back with a return, and they does look like Dignitas are going to be able to mount that comeback, and the nice re-entry from their spawn finally stop this payload from just moving incessantly forward here. And obviously a great play there from Bromas to come over and help Vayneless out a little bit late, but nonetheless still able to get that trade kill, which is very, very important given their positioning next to this spawn.
Oh, here comes a Graviton Surge. Where are we going to see that Pulse Bomb coming out? That's going to be a double kill for Bromas. They're going to be able to wipe them, and now What7 sitting on the Urge Shatter. He's going to be looking for that next positioning for that ultimate as the rotations are coming out. But right now, on the side of Misfits, they've got four to work with, so they're in a really great spot here. They do have that sound barrier as the fallback, just in case the Earth Shatter does come out and connects onto a good number of them.
And Nevix now swapped over to the Tracer off that Genji, so we've now seen Manitin and Nevix on that Tracer, and we see the sound barrier starting things off here for Misfits, and an Earth Shatter coming out actually on What Seven's part, yeah. And we do actually see him backed up, and he's incredibly low. Nevix right behind him. They're finding kill after kill after kill. Linxer going to be forced to pull out the whole hog just to try to get some distance here, and that's not going to do much as they are going to be finding the kill on Toxican. They now will be able to get aggressive, find the kill on Vayneless more than likely, but Linxer coming through with the hook, finds Nevix, and that's a big pickup for them to slow down the pace of the aggression here from Misfits. And with Linxer still up in this fight, it's going to be hard for Misfits to stay in this one. And another one! This guy is insane! What?
So Vic does get out. He had that projected barrier to keep him alive. Here comes the Graviton Surge. Got eaten up by Toxican. And so, huge ultimate off the table. Now, Laser coming and gets the kill onto Reinforced. Pulse Bomb isn't able to connect onto Vayneless. Everyone's purple on the side of Misfits, and now they're getting cleaned up. Linxer here coming alive. Madison trying his best to stay alive, but it's going to be Bromas that cleans that up. 2 seconds left. They have to stay on the point. It is an overtime now, but no one is anywhere near it. And finally, they're going to put a stop to Misfits here as Dignitas.
Misfits still went a pretty good distance, although, I mean, Linxer, definitely a huge nuisance for them on that defensive Roadhog, creating a lot of pick potential and being very, very lethal for Dignitas, and certainly Misfits struggled to deal with him with the fact that he was just landing hook after hook after hook. I mean, lots of them consecutively as well, securing fights for his team, and now we're going to be seeing Misfits on the defensive here, looking to see what kind of composition they want to use. It is going to be a dive comp, so we'll have to see how this is going to work out at the moment. I mean, again, they did have a decent distance covered, but ultimately, I mean, Misfits has been a little bit, it's hard to put in words, because it's not really like disappointing or lackluster. It's just a little bit less than what you would have expected, which, again, Misfits, one of the teams that came through that trade, and arguably, I mean, them and Rogue, it was basically just going to be a contest to see who was going to be able to be the most successful after that, because it seemed as though those were the two rosters that kind of came out of it ahead. the most, but Misfits hasn't been having the same kind of levels of performance as the Rogue roster has had over in NA. And, you know, there could be some talk about, you know, how the two regions are interacting and everything like that, and how, where everybody stands and all that. But what's being displayed here is Misfits not looking as strong as what we're seeing from Rogue at the moment. And it's hard to, again, it's kind of hard to contest that. I mean, they haven't played each other and everything like that, but we just haven't seen that same dominating performance that we're probably, I mean, we're basically looking for that. We're looking for Misfits to have that dominant performance. So now on the defensive side, we will see Reinforce holding very, very far forward here on this Winston, and now looking to get aggressive. He's just going to be holding here and with an opportunity to just jump back. So this is, while this isn't incredibly safe, he is going to get sighted. So now he's going to be forced to come back, not going to be able to follow the plan to the T, and actually sticking very aggressively close to the spawn door. He's not moving anywhere.
What, seven jumping right on top of Zave, and that's that positioning that Lucius have to really play if they want to try and use this dive composition. So Toxkin with two picks off immediately, Zave and Reinforce now out of the equation. The rest of Misfits are just going to go ahead and jump forward to reset with the team, try and contest for as long as possible, but they get cleaned up largely by Dignitas here.
Man, they get cleaned up quick, but because of the fact that they were held so far forward, they basically just stole 40 seconds for free, because ultimately, like, nothing really would have happened here anyways. The only thing that they're doing is essentially just giving up control of Big Earls, but given the fact that they are a dive comp, it doesn't really amount to much. So really, nothing really lost in the most part other than just ult percentage here, which is going to be a factor for sure. But now with Manton coming through with a pulse bomb, able to find two kills, very pivotal ones as well, as Toxican somehow, that tracking, just unbelievable, and Discord's coming out as well. That's going to be Tevik falling, and Toxican able to, with zero energy again, find a couple of kills there, and now Misfits with a third attempt to come back in and try to steal some time. So despite the fact that they haven't won any fights, they're still taking some decent time because of their ability to just get back up onto the point. They were very aggressive with that first one. And Toxican, given the fact that he doesn't have too much energy, isn't going to be able to get that Graviton, so they might be able to hold this one out, but they have to protect Zebesai, and that's not going to be the case at all, as Linkser comes through with that Dragon Blade and finds that kill very quickly, very, very efficiently as well.
Yep, that's a 2-for-1 trade. Now what, seven on top of Tevik, who is on the high ground here. Mountain and Tevik, the DPS duo, just trying their best to stall, but all of these teamfights going in favor of Dignitas right now. They're setting a great pace, 4 minutes and 35 seconds. That's about a minute 30 faster than Misfits did on their push.
So now if Dignitas can continue this momentum and pushing it forward. I mean, obviously Misfits with a lot better positioning to try to take advantage of the ults that they've been able to generate, or very close to being able to generate here, as Reinforced and Manton very close, as well as Zebesai and Nevix. And Nevix already starting things off with a kill onto Bromas here and getting back in there. Transcendence coming out there from Vainless. Nevix getting taken down pretty low. Does have that Dragon Blade ready to go now, as we did see Manton going for that Pulse Bomb, not finding anything initially, and it's Nevix coming out with a couple of kills here. Going to be able to take out Toxican as well with Reinforce coming through. So they wind up using four ultimates there. Four ultimates, if I'm not mistaken, as with Manton coming back up to 60%. So that's definitely good for the Tracer to get back up. But nonetheless, they still are only really going to have Tevik in this next one. Not going to be able to use the Nano Boost along with it, so he's not going to have that extra little firepower. As Zebesai did have to use that, I believe, last fight there.
Yeah, they need a stall time for Zave to try and get that sound barrier, but already Tevik does go down. Here comes the Graviton Surge. It lands onto Reinforce. Nevix was able to dash on out, and with the deflect, he gets the kill onto Bromas. Now we do have the Primal Rage coming out on the side of Dignitas. What, seven though? Found no one quite there. Jumps all the way back onto the payload, trying to get to Zave. But yeah, during that entire time, that payload barely getting pushed forward. Now the Pulse Bomb does come out, and Manton gets two off of it.
Now the question is going to be if Tevik can stay alive here long enough for the rest of his team to get over here and support him. He's gotten down pretty low, and Vainless looking for that kill. Has the Discord on him, or rather had it, but does again. Now looking for that kill. I mean, Bromas actually gets hit by a body rocket there, forced to recall if I'm not mistaken. I don't actually know if he wound up using it. He did wind up using it, so not going to have that available. And we will see Tevik coming out with that TAC Visor. Not going to get boosted, though. Soundbear coming out, and he's getting contested. Links are all over him with the Dragon Blade, and he's actually going to lose that fight. as Linkster and Vainless with two kills, giving that advantage to Dignitas as they're pushing forward. But again, this entire defensive strategy for Misfits is to just waste time here. That's all they're doing. Even though they haven't won very many fights, or maybe even any at all, they're just trying to contest this for as long as possible. That's the only hope here. And they're doing a pretty fantastic job of that so far, but Linkster finally able to run that one through and finish off that contesting and reinforce the last one to die off for Misfits here. 2 minutes remaining, and they should be able to cap this out. We might see a contest before this point caps. We'll have to see. I mean, reinforce not going to be up though, so probably not actually. Oh, they're jumping out anyways.
Nevix has that deflect. He's got the nano. He's got the dragon blade. He jumps right on top of Toxian, taking him on now. Back to the payload here. He's dropping a little bit low, but it's going to be okay as Manton comes in with the help of Tevix, starting to clean up the entirety of Dignitas here. It's just down to Linkster and Bayless. Make that just Linkster. No one else at this point. So they're going to be able to hold it at about 3 meters there, but still a minute and 30 on the clock for Dignitas just to try and get this next checkpoint.
And we will see Misfits holding through. And now Nevix actually with that great entry in there. They didn't have Reinforce actually at all in that last fight until about halfway through when he finally was able to jump on. But still that Nanoblade just gave them so much pressure, and they were able to go through, find the space as well for Tevik and find those kills and make the stop. And definitely looking very solid now, but Toxican going to be able to find that kill on Nevix, who was sitting at about 8 HP when he went forward, and Linkster now with a great opportunity to Dragon Blade here, does shut down to Vic. He pulls out the Tac Visor, but it's not actually going to get pulled out all the way as the animation didn't finish. So he's going to have that in the next fight. Discord going on to reinforce. They're going to find that elimination as well. And now with around 35 seconds, it's going to wind up being, they wind up getting that cap. And now just over 2 minutes to close this one out is going to be Linkster swapping over to the Roadhog. Was fantastic on the defensive side. And we'll have to see if he's able to have a similar performance here, as Toxican is actually over to the Zarya himself. And now 3-tank strat coming out from Dignitas here.
Yeah, Nevix though had swapped off also, so now we got the 2-2-2 as the payload is starting to make its way through this warehouse here. What, 7 facing off against Reinforce. Here comes the Pulse Bomb. Sound Barrier comes out on the side of Dignitas. Toxican gets the first kill, but now Tevik finally with an opening with that Tactical Visor. He's got the Nano Boost, gets that first kill onto Vainless, gets a second onto Evoke. Both supports down, no sustain on the side of Dignitas right now. Tevik is just cleaning up.
And what, 7 pushed back a bit, and they want to find a late kill onto this one. And these guys are just trying to contest for a long time. Toxican with high energy, they need to find that kill very, very quickly, but he's going to get healed up. He's going to be a priority for them to heal up as well because of that high energy that he has. But if Misfits can find that kill, it'll be a nice reset for the fight. But trades coming out once again. They really need to focus down Toxican here, and Tevik almost taken out as Linkster fights too. And that's going to be Misfits forced to fall back a little bit. Reinforce with that Earth Shatter as he's on the Reinhardt right now. And we do see comp changing up. Manitin may swap. We'll have to see. He's on the Tracer at the moment, but Nevix swapped over to that Zarya, so he might make that swap. But he actually is going to stay on the Tracer at the moment. And Reinforce looking for an opportunity to make the most of this Shatter. What, 7 with a Shatter of his own coming up here as well.
Toxican with the Graviton Surge lands onto 3. Zebuside is going to go down for that. Already 3 members going on down. 1-7 did try to go for that Earth Shatter, but doesn't matter now. Manitin's the only one that's on here as Tevik does get hammered on down. It's going to be Dignitas completing out the map against Misfits, and they're going to take the first map of the.
If we're going to be seeing that same thing come out, and if it does, how Misfits is going to be able to contend with it, because so far it's been a pretty solid approach. And it's worked out quite well for them at the moment through all the instances of King's Road that we've seen Dignitas going on. And that this is actually not only the third time we've seen Dignitas today, but the third time we've seen them on King's Row as well. But nonetheless, again, Misfits not super consistent on this map, especially on defense. But let's see if they can turn things around here, as obviously they sense that they're comfortable enough to be able to take this here. And we do see Nevix actually going over to the McCree with Tevik actually on the Genji at the moment. So they're going to be running a 2-2-2 and trying to use the McCree. Again, just very strong in this meta, I would say. I think more teams are going to be picking this up over time, because not only does it deal with Pharah's pretty well, against teams who are still trying to use Pharah, Toxican at the moment is on it, but he's very likely to switch over to that Zarya unless Bromas picks it up, and he does indeed. But nonetheless, it's good against that, but also the flashbang helps out a lot against barrier plays where teams are trying to stack on the Lucio behind the barrier, and just you can get a flashbang over, not only shut down the Reinhardt, but also get a lot of damage on everybody who's standing behind that as well. So I definitely like this. I definitely think that McCree is going to come through and be a little bit more prominent in the meta now that we've seen that Lucio change happen.
All right, so Linkser on this Hanzo hasn't found anything quite yet, but all it takes is just one good scatter arrow, just a headshot across the corner, tries to connect it onto Tevik there on the statue, but he hasn't been moved quite yet. It's going to be reinforced, getting dragged in with that hook. Now it's going to be a 1-for-1, make that a 2-for-1 trade as Linkser finally connects with a headshot onto Zebicide now. 2-for-2 trade, but Toxkin once again coming in with that hook. Unfortunately, he drops low, has to back off to Vic, getting some free damage off, but now things going in favor of Dignitas.
But Linkser getting dealt with a little bit here to Vic, trying to contest him, and he's actually going to be taken out. Toxkin able to make that play. Dignitas with a, this is a pretty early cap here up against Misfits, and again, Misfits with the inability to make that hold on the first point. Linkser just setting himself up, looking for an opportunity to go ahead and find a couple of extra hits, and doesn't find anything initially, but they're not going to be able to push that payload through the archway at all. We're going to be seeing Misfits in a position to try to contest this, and we've seen teams actually hold out on this stage of the map for minutes on end, so maybe Misfits can turn things back around on this particular stage of the map here. Nevix with that Deadeye ready, as well as Tevik, good to go. I mean, they have a lot of options in terms of ultimates, but they have to be careful of Bromus and Linkser. That's been a big issue for teams. They have to be able to scatter and make sure that they live through that one.
Now we do have the Dragonblade coming up for Tevik. He's already gotten the kill onto Linkser, reinforced with a great shatter there. That's going to be a 3-for-1 trade. They're on the hunt for Evoke. He's cut out just a little bit, but he will be able to get out with the help of Vainless there. 4 minutes and 40 seconds left to work with. Right now, the offense looking in great shape. They've got 5 ultimates, almost the 6th Evoke sitting about 7% away. But more importantly, they've got that Graviton Dragon Strike combo to work with.
And again, this is that switch that we were talking about before. Tevik actually going over to that Pharah, because no one really is going to be able to contest him. But he's not going to be able to make it in time to actually get into this fight. So Misfits now going to be trying to battle back. And Zavi actually does find a kill, but is going to be eliminated there by Linkser. And Tevik not able to actually even really be in that fight, only long enough at least to get a kill on Evoke. And that gives them 32% ult charge. So not coming away with nothing, but certainly not what they wanted. They certainly wanted him a lot sooner. But nonetheless, still, I do like this swap because really, I mean, no one's able to hard counter, just delete him. I mean, Vainless is going to be kind of in charge of doing some of that, and Linkser might be trying to throw some arrows at him, but ultimately, Tevik should be able to dodge most of those out, and he should be able to get some good free damage. Nonetheless, Graviton coming out, though, from Bromos, yeah. And he's looking for that combination once again.
It connects onto 2. That's going to be Linkser with the follow-up damage there. Already a 64 in favor of Dignitas as Toxican cleans up Nevix, and now things all going in favor of Dignitas. They're setting a great pace here. 3 minutes, 20 seconds left on the clock as they're turning the spinal bend here. They're going to be able to get that second or that first checkpoint, and already Bromos and What7 holding up front here just to stop out anyone from trying to get in.
We will see Vainless with that nano boost just looking to put on someone. Linkser did just actually wind up utilizing that ult, so we'll have to see switching there off of that Hanzo. Now he doesn't have his ult, but Reinforce taken down pretty low. Actually does get eliminated as Toxkin finds that nice right click from a decent range, and Zave pushing What7 off of the map completely. We do see the barrage coming out from Tevik, looking for some more kills. He finds 3 himself, and now pushing the rest of these guys off the map. Going forward, should be able to kill off Bromus, but he's pretty dangerously low. Still going to be able to find that kill, and Misfits finally mount a solid defense here with Tevik coming through with a nice barrage.
Yeah, it was off the back of Zave getting a great right-click kill on to What7, who was laid on his back. Now, 3 minutes and 50 seconds to work with on the side of Dignitas. They don't have any ultimates quite yet. They are working their way toward that whole hog, but they have to contend with an Earth Shatter. We'll see if Reinforce can land it. Nevix can follow up with that Deadeye too.
I don't imagine the Deadeye is going to do all too much, and we saw the barrier, or the projected barrier from the Zarya come out onto What7 there, and that provided all that they needed against the flashbang. And we do see the Graviton coming out, but the payload's right in the way. He's not going to be able to find anything with it, so no value of that. Oh, still, they come around the corner right into it. And now just enough damage was provided by that Deadeye that they might be able to close this out. Bromas trying to find a kill does indeed, but that's going to be wiped up. And Tevik slept up top, should be able to come back from being awoken here. And What7 pushed back out of position, still going to be able to get away given the fact that he does have that healing. But they're going to take his barrier down low and force him to regenerate that. Linkster back onto the Hanzo though in the meantime. Didn't like the swap of the soldier, and seems as though he's just gone back over to the Hanzo and trying to get this combo running for the team again. Just under 3 minutes here, 240 to be exact.
Yeah, Tevik still going largely uncontested as Reinforce gets that kill onto What7. Bromas put to sleep, but it's going to be Vainless connecting those shots onto Tevik. And now we do have the Graviton Surge coming on out. It's only going to connect onto Toxkin, and he's just getting healed throughout that. Bromas does have the nano. Pushing forward with that is Evoke, is just in the middle of the entirety of Misfits. It's Reinforce coming in, four-man shatter. He's gonna follow up. It's gonna be Nevix with a double kill off that. Even the charge coming in, counter charge by What7, keeping it alive for now, but he will be able to reset now. The defense doing a great job so far of holding on as we are here in the boundary portion. 2 minutes left for Dignitas to try and complete out this map. Now they are still sitting on that Dragon Strike combo with the Graviton Surge.
And Toxican moving over to the McCree himself, not only for the reasons that we talked about before, but also just to try to deal with Tevik in the sky at the moment. That's a big reason as well, and we're seeing that swap happen, and now moving forward to try to make the most of it. Graviton coming out, Dragon Strike to follow, and that should find two kills, and they do indeed. Three, actually, as Reinforce comes forward, looking to try to turn things around. Not going to happen. Zebesai going to fall as well, and just Manitin on the point. High energy is going to be lost. Dignitas moving forward. Now, they don't have too many options here. Earthshatter is really kind of the only thing that they have, other than the high ground here that Linkster has just gotten for himself. And now Misfits with an opportunity to jump back in. 1:15 on the clock. Tevik actually going to get taken down quickly. Bromas with two kills already, and we're seeing the Graviton jump down. Not going to be able to find anything initially. Manitin trying to find a kill. That's going to come out onto Vainless, and that's going to be it. 1:04 is the time that Dignitas makes as they run all the way through this map here on King's Row.
And those 4 seconds could be quite crucial, actually, on the side of Dignitas. If this goes into overtime on Misfits' like final push to try and complete out the map, they're not going to have a second opportunity. So I like that they were able to get that secondary win condition on the side of Dig there. It was so close. If they could have just stalled out, it would have helped out Misfits immensely. But still, their offense, we have to see it as we do swap sides here. On the side of Dignitas, though, it looks like we might be going for that 2-2-2 composition. Bromas on the McCree, Linkster on the Tracer instead of a Genji. And, of course, Toxican now on Roadhog and What7 rounding up that comp with that Reinhardt.
So, very consistent performances, actually, from this particular combination with those ults coming together. Given the fact that teams are, you know, typically stacking a lot more now, that Graviton Dragon Strike combo just works so well, and that's exactly the reason why we saw it worked in the last time we saw it come out in the meta, is that teams were stacking a lot and trying to stay together as a death ball, with the Beyblade combo, of course, being the most prominent and most effective ultimate combination. Teams were trying to just, again, be death ball, be very close together, trying to make the most use out of the Reaper. But then when you bring in the possibility of bringing in a Zarya and a Hanzo on the attack, you give the opportunity to kind of just punish that. And it's very, very strong. We've already seen the effect of it as Misfits fell to it a little bit there. But nonetheless, we are going to be seeing Tevik actually on the Hanzo here. And this has been something I haven't seen in a little bit, but he's going to be bringing it out. And I'm very, very excited to see this, as we already saw Linkster doing quite well with it. I'm curious to see if Tevik's going to have a similar, worse, or better performance here.
All right, now the gates are opening up. This is going to be Misfits' opportunity to attack. They do have Nevix on that Soldier 76, so any real follow-up damage is going to come from him for the most part, as they are making their way across that statue already. We do have Nevix going for that high ground. He's trying to contest against Linkster, who does dash in on him. They've got to be careful. They are being forced back. He is cut off just a little bit, but he'll be able to retreat with the rest of his team.
But we did see Tevik actually swapping off to the Pharah. They slotted the McCree there, and then he was like, you know what, I don't even want to deal with this. And then he goes over to the Genji, and he's going to be in a little bit of a Genji battle, and they actually ping-pong some damage back and forth between each other. And then eventually Misfits pulling out as Dignitas actually do successfully defend the point here, at least initially. And now 45 seconds off the clock here with Misfits. Nothing to show for it so far other than Zebesai actually being pretty far ahead in terms of the ult charge. Not too far away from Baneless though, and Bromas actually dishing out a ton of damage. Look for him to try to get aggressive. They're pushing down Reinforce's barrier a lot actually. And both Reinhardts need to be very careful. But Nevix already finding a pick on the Lynxer here.
Yeah, Manatid pushes forward. He's got that nano boost in tow. Now they are forcing back Dignitas so far here on the defense. Both supports really caught out by Reinforce. It's going to be that fire strike cleaning up. Watt 7 is trading on back now. Broma starting to open up, but great deflect coming up from Tevik there. We'll get the kill onto Toxicant. And now Misfits already one tick on the board as Lynxer is trying his best to contest, but Manatid will be able to melt him away.
And now Nevix going forward does have his tac visor available. Zebesai already used that nano boost, I believe on Manatin in the last fight, to try to create some extra pressure and get that the Graviton Surge up as soon as possible. So they have a lot of options here. I mean, both teams are going to have a lot, obviously. I mean, the only ultimate that won't be in play is Zabe's Sound Barrier. So certainly you could see Dignitas coming through and making good, efficient use of their ultimates to try to come out. But given the fact that it is going to be basically a bloodbath between the two teams, it could go either way here. We see the Graviton coming out already, though.
Yeah, Manatin with a great positioning there inside the cafe. Landed onto the majority of the defense, and they're immediately going to get cleaned up. To Vic just getting those dash resets, and now they are setting a great pace here on the streets phase. They still have three ultimates to work with. Zebesai might be able to build up his nano visor or nano in time for that visor conjunction, as the defense are just rallying together here for a final hold before it gets to the checkpoint.
Zebesai, yeah, definitely looking for that second nano boost. And he's giving that information over to Nevix, and we're seeing Zebesai go for a play. Actually, I think it got reflected there, if I'm not mistaken. And Lynxer going forward. They're going to be contested by Toxicant. Toxicant going to be able to eliminate him as Lynxer actually comes through with the actual kill. And now he's finding three for himself. Tevik trying to return with some of his own, but not going to be the case. Reinforce just forced to back out. He's going to be safe. And Dignitas utilizing basically everything at their disposal to be able to take that fight. And now look at what the advantage Misfits has been able to gather for themselves. Zebesai with that nano boost this time around. Nevix, tac visor ready. Misfits should be able to get this pretty easy.
This is going to be a really great team fight for them, just as long as no heroics really come out. Now they are starting to push forward back onto that payload. We do see the nano coming on out. Nevix now with that tactical visor finds that first kill onto Baneless, but immediately gets taken out by Toxicant though. Reinforce keeping this alive, finds that kill onto Watt 7, and now it's going to be a 5v4 in favor of Misfits, as Toxicant is going to be the next victim of Reinforce. And now Evoke just trying his best to keep this point alive, keep it contested, but he's still in the middle of four members of Misfits. He's getting swung on by Reinforce. It's going to be Manatin that gets the kill onto Bromas, and now it's just Lynxer here trying to contest for as long as he can. Reinforce, great fire strike, will complete that out. And they're going to be able to get this checkpoint. They're going to have about 4 minutes on the clock here trying to complete out the map.
Vic with that Dragon Blade certainly trying to make the most of it, I would have to imagine, with Manatin coming close to that Graviton Surge, but he doesn't have any energy, so if he does wind up dropping it, the damage is going to have to come from elsewhere. You know, Reinforce jumping in and contesting that, and that's going to come out pretty soon. He was hoping to actually drop it right there, and he actually just jumps off the map. Him and Reinforce just both get knocked off the map, and I think they did it of their own volition.
Yeah, Lynxer already committed the Dragon Blade there, so I don't know which one came first, the Dragon or the Fall, but still, they're just going to go ahead and lose about a minute on their clock there as they do come in for that re-engage. They've got that Graviton to work with along with the Dragon Blade. Here we go. It connects onto three. Fortunately, the damage isn't quite there yet as the Sound Barrier does come out on the side of Misfits. Reinforced with a great shatter, takes out Toxicant and Watt 7. Both of the tanks down now. They're just starting to clean up here is Misfits.
Lynxer now going to be eliminated there. Zabe coming up with two kills on the end. But yeah, Earthshatter is definitely swinging the fight twice there, as Whatseven was able to shut down Tevik a little bit, and that was a big reason why the damage wasn't there on the Graviton initially, but then reinforced with a return of his own. And we do see Tevik jumping forward already with that Nano Blade, and it's going to be Bromas trying to make a play here with a... Oh, he does manage to get the Deadeye out in time to save the day here, and that's going to be Bromas mounting the defense as we do see... Oh, Whatseven somehow able to stay on the ground there, and he manages to stay alive. Nonetheless, not going to amount to anything. 220 remains for them to close this one out, but obviously they want to be able to close it out with time to spare, so they have another opportunity to go ahead and try to at least have an opportunity alongside the side of Dignitas if it should go into a kind of a tiebreaker scenario here in overtime.
Alright, Dragonblade once again coming out from Linkster. Nothing answered quite on yet. He gets that first kill, gets a second, getting the resets. Now he's onto Zebasai, but he will finally go down. That's a 2-for-1 trade. Make that a 3-for-1 as the offense is starting to get cleaned up here. They're going to have to fall back. They do have a few more opportunities to try and finish off the map, but looks like things are starting to wind down. Nevix is still holding on to that, to the tactical visor there. He's waiting for a prime opportunity as Reinforce is wicking his way towards that Earth Shatter.
We will see Linkster looking for some opportunities to try to get a lot of damage into Toxican's Graviton Surge. It's kind of going to come up right now, and he drops it right into that, and they do manage to find a lot of damage already with two kills. Got a lot of people low. That's the rest of them. Clean sweep as Tevik is the last person alive. He's going to drop, and that is a team kill for the side of Dignitas. And now time is equal out. 104 here ticks out, and now it's under a minute. And really, I mean, they have a couple of options coming in soon. Misfits should be able to get a Graviton into a Dragon Blade, maybe a Nano Boost involved as well. Sound Barrier coming up pretty soon, but it's going to be Dignitas with one first, and Lynx are going to get one of his own. If Whatseven can shut down some of the aggression here with a nice Shatter, they're going to be in a great position. But look at Reinforce opening things up, man. What a monster.
But Whatseven answers in kind without, I think it was a six-man Earth Shatter coming on out. Reinforce getting put to sleep. Now he's getting swung on. Here comes the Graviton Surge. Do they have the damage to follow this up? The Whatseven is crippled for now, but he's got that shield up. Madison in the back line trying to get some free damage off, but Linkster's on the hunt now. Nevix is able to complete that kill onto Valence. 5 seconds onto Whatseven. This might be the window of opportunity, but at this point, time is starting to dwindle down. They've got 14 seconds left to try and complete out the map.
Manitin, with all the energy in the world to work with here, has been able to definitely, I mean, be very integral in terms of trying to get on there and support out. But now we do see Linkster trying to come alive with the Dragon Blade, forced to go into that block, that deflecting stance, and they already did find two kills, which is certainly looking good for them. But Misfits finding three of their own. That's make it four there, actually, as it's going to be Zebasai in the back supporting the team. And because of the fact that the D.Va of Bromas wasn't jumping over to the point, he was trying to contest Zebasai, he wasn't able to get over to the point, and that's going to be in overtime. Misfits closing this one out. And now they're going to have another opportunity to attack here with only a minute, but they gave, of course, they don't attack because they didn't finish, and it was over a minute for the other side. So now things are going to swap back over, actually, and Dignitas could potentially close this one out. And Linkster looks like he's going to be going back over to that same exact style that we've been seeing them very consistently. I mean, it's not going to be a surprise what they're going to pull out. Linkster on the Hanzo with Bromas's Zarya there. We'll have to see if a minute and 4 seconds is enough time for them to close this out or not. The question is, I don't actually know if they get a tick. Is that it? Do they technically win?
Oh, I haven't actually had an opportunity to play with the new percentage point here. Do they? No, I think they have to actually complete out the tick.
Well, we're about to find out because it
is. New and strange frontiers here are being explored.
We've been casting so much lately that it's just been, haven't had much opportunity to play yet. But nonetheless, it's just, we're going to have the ability to find out now as it is going to be coming through overtime, of course. And now Misfits have to defend here. And obviously, they don't want to give anything away anyways, but not a lot of time. We'll have to see if Linkster can create some picks on this Hanzo, and again, it really hasn't been super, super effective. It's just been the pressure that he's been putting out has been a lot, and he's been able to find the picks when he needs to. Just not super crazy. We'll have to see. Again, it's just going to come down to this time, obviously. Oh, there it is onto Nevix!
Yeah, charge does come out from Reinforce. Unfortunately, he's not able to get that pin there. He drops real low. He's anti-healed. Linkster is going to be able to complete that kill. Watt 7 now charging forward. Does not connect onto anyone, but he's getting some free damage off right now. They're starting to get forced back on the side of Misfits, and Zebesai starting to get melted down by Bromas. He does get healed up just a little bit, but will finally fall down to the hammer of Zebesai, and things looking great as the nano boost comes out to Watt 7. He gets the kill onto Zavi. Here comes the Earth Shatter. Doesn't quite connect, but they are cleaning up. And it's Dignitas doing
it.
They've run the gauntlet three matches straight through the loser's bracket. They're moving on to the loser's bracket final here. They've secured $2,700. And now they'll be facing off against the loser of and...